Hi guys, this is Rob from Grandstand Productions. I hope you guys are having a good day, because I'd bet seeing Xander Bogaerts in a Padres uniform would just about ruin it for you. As I just said, Xander Bogaerts is now officially a member of the San Diego Padres, and was recently introduced at a press conference at Petco Park. And yes, he looks as weird as you could possibly imagine him looking in another uniform, other than the Boston Red Sox. That leaves the Red Sox with a face of the franchise-sized hole at shortstop, which is one of the most important positions anywhere around the diamond. Today, we'll look at where the Red Sox should have gone from this incredibly unfortunate position they found themselves in. The first thing I'll talk about in this video is already at least reportedly a done deal, but it has yet to be officially announced by the Red Sox Twitter account as of the time this was written. The Red Sox have signed 28-year-old Japanese left fielder Masataka Yoshida to a 5-year, $90 million contract. Additionally, they owe the Oryx Buffaloes $15.4 million due to the posting system. He could be the next Juan Soto with his combination of plate discipline and bat-to-ball skills, which are both a level rarely seen in a whole generation of players. But many have much worse opinion on Yoshida's talent. According to one anonymous MLB scout, he's worth only half the contract that the Red Sox are paying him. Another scout said he's capped out to be a fourth outfielder on a contender with a deep outfield. Yet another said in a quote, "I have no words." He has a lot to prove with all the criticism in comparison. Many scouts said that the 2021 MVP winner and two-way sensation Shohei Ohtani hit like a high schooler. Despite the criticism, Yoshida collected a batting title in Japan, which is considered by many in sport to be equivalent or slightly superior to North America's upper minor leagues, also known as AAA. But it remains to be seen whether or not that contact skills will be transferred over smoothly at the highest level. Another risk for him is his defensive skill level. He's viewed as somewhere between average and below average defensively, a left fielder by trade. A move to right might be necessary if they prefer to have Alex Verdugo, considered by many in the sport to be a superior defender, in the more important left field. The only reason that's significant is the iconic green monster, which Verdugo already has a grasp of, with the rather complicated ins and outs of fielding with the monster looming overhead. The pickup of Yoshida is an interesting one, and if he fails, people in the upper management and the decision-making part of the front office will likely start getting fired at a massive scale. Now that we're done talking about Masataka Yoshida, I'll point out for the sake of your mental health that nothing else in the rest of this video is anywhere near a done deal, let alone about to happen. An interesting option for the Red Sox to replace Xander Bogaerts as shortstop is Carlos Correa. Correa already has a close relationship with Red Sox manager Alex Cora from their time together with the Houston Astros, and that may be enough to make a hypothetical offer from the Red Sox to perk Correa's ears a little more than an equal offer from a random team. That and an amazing fan base would potentially help bring him to Boston. A potential Carlos Correa contract would be something like 10 years, $325 million. Correa spent his 2022 campaign with the Minnesota Twins, where he hit .291 with 22 home runs, driving in 64 RBIs, also appearing in a solid 136 games at a somewhat hitter-friendly ballpark at Target Field. Additionally, Correa is also an above-average defender at shortstop, which is a very well-valued position, both literally and figuratively. If there's any legitimate concern with Correa, it's his involvement in the 2017 Astros sign-stealing scandal and his odd, at times even somewhat disturbing takes on teams paying him lots and lots of money, which sort of leaves a bad taste in the mouths of any fan paying him all that cash. That's not even an on-field issue, showing just how much of a true ball player and athlete Correa is. Another potentially even more intriguing young player who could take over for Xander Bogaerts at shortstop is Dansby Swanson. In his 2022 season, which he spent with Atlanta, Swanson slashed .277, hitting 25 big flies and an OPS of .776. His most impressive attribute among impressive attributes is his durability. Last season, Swanson led all of Major League Baseball with 162 games played, and it gets even better. Swanson is expected to be even cheaper than both Correa and Bogaerts, with a potential deal somewhere in the neighborhood of 6 years and $150 million, which is a low one for one of the best shortstops available. The only concern is his lack of consistency. He's pretty much only had two really good seasons, which just so happens to be his last two, which helps the case that more consistency is to come in the future for the former first overall draft pick. Additionally, he's also younger than either. At only 28 years old, he's also a premier defender at a premier position. He's definitely a name to watch, and any team would benefit from adding Swanson, with who not only has experience, but also a World Series level pedigree, and the skills to help anchor a mid to back end of pretty much any contender's lineup. Moving on to pitching, one of the under-the-radar picks that the Red Sox could consider pursuing is right-handed pitcher Noah Syndergaard. He spent his 2022 season with the Angels before being traded to the Phillies at the trade deadline, pitching to a 3.94 ERA with a 1.255 whip and 134 innings of work. While those numbers are solid, Syndergaard's health has always been a legitimate question mark. His last season saw him make 25 starts. While that's not a ton, it's still quite a bit for someone who's often injured. Syndergaard also has another concern with his Twitter account, which he will post somewhat occasional controversial takes on baseball. And that's never a good look for any team. The Red Sox might go the trade route in order to address their pitching needs. There is one trade partner that is perfect for this because they're a plethora of pitching and not really being a playoff team these days. That team is the Miami Marlins, who have Sandy Alcantara and Pablo Lopez as possible ace types. They also have a guy like Max Meyer and Yuri Perez waiting in the wings to take their place. If they move a Lopez or Alcantara, let's talk Lopez. He was almost moved mid-season to the Yankees, but Miami backed out last minute. Now, what might it take for the Red Sox to acquire the 26-year-old righty? Here's what we think it might take. Boston would acquire right-handed pitcher Pablo Lopez, who had a 10-10 record with a 3.75 ERA and 180 innings pitched, had 174 strikeouts, and had a 1.17 whip in 32 games, and also throw in a low-level prospect. Miami would acquire right-handed pitcher Tanner Houck, who was 5-4 with a 3.15 ERA and 60 innings pitched, had 56 strikeouts and a 1.18 whip in 32 games. Shortstop Cutter Coffey, who's the Red Sox number 16 prospect. Shortstop Edison Paulino, the Red Sox number 13 prospect. And shortstop Brainer Bonassi, the Red Sox number 15 prospect. Now that we're through with discussing free agency, we're going to change the subject over to the Rafael Devers contract extension talks, which according to reports are still ongoing, but not gaining very much traction for either side, and aren't anywhere near fruition. According to a source close to Devers, his close friend Xander Bogaerts signing elsewhere will not impact whether or not he signs an extension to keep him in Boston for the rest of his career. When asked about Devers, Red Sox CBO Chaim Bloom said this, "Rafi for sure is somebody we want to build around," and then continued on, "It's certainly something we want to do often as we can. Devers has been somebody that we love and want right at the center of everything we hope to accomplish, obviously in 2023, but more importantly in the years beyond, because those are the years he's not under control. We're hoping to change that." Bloom's words are near perfect summary of an incredibly complex situation regarding Rafael Devers' ongoing extension progress. We say this in a lot of our videos, the moves that the Red Sox have made are good, but should be just a start to what they have in store for us this offseason. As always, there's plenty of moves that the Red Sox can make, but it's just a matter of time to see what they do. As always, thank you for tuning into this YouTube video. If you're new and you're seeing this on your YouTube suggestions, please make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to Grandstand Productions. We make Red Sox content weekly. Also, if you guys want to hear more things Red Sox and you want more in-depth information about the Red Sox, check out our podcast called Inside the Sox, hosted by Grandstand Productions' own Kevin Baver and myself, Rob Anglin. As always, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. We appreciate everybody tuning in. If you are new, like I said, please like and subscribe. If you're already subscribed, thank you for supporting so much. And as always, this is Rob from Grandstand Productions signing off.
Tell your story. I'm gonna tell you.